5 years since I've been living on this desert island. At first alone for 4 years, then for 1 year with Friday. And now, alone again. My friend is hiding. I don't understand. I saved his life and he doesn't want to live with me any longer. Yet he stayed on the island. But I don't see him anymore.
Friday!
I wounded his pride. But if I don't see him, how can I tell him I'm sorry? How long is he going to stay hidden? If only he doesn't try to hollow out a canoe to return to his own country. He told me that before, he didn't know of the existence of my island, that only his enemies knew it. It's several days sailing and a dangerous crossing. We had given up the idea of doing it together. But he's capable of trying it alone, even though he hardly knows the course to follow. And I'll find myself alone again.
Friday! Oh! Friday! Friday!
Still on the island. He isn't abandoning me. Friday. Friday. I never saw my dog so sad. It isn't just Friday's leaving me. He must be ill. He's an old dog now. For some time now, he hasn't been so eager to take a run with me. He hardly eats, he who ate everything. Poor Dick. Are you going to abandon me? You too? Thank you. He doesn't want to drink. He's very sick and I have no medicine. When I fell ill, I hadn't anything to heal me, but I got well anyway. But he needs medicine. If only Friday were here. Perhaps he might know some native herb unknown to me. What can I do? Nothing. My old companion. He had been the only living thing I could converse with for such a long time. I also spoke to the goats, to the bird. But Dick was the only one who understood me.
Me understand.
Here he is, back again. No explanations were necessary. I thought I was superior to him, and I wasn't, that's all. I had considered Friday my slave, and he couldn't bear that. Now that I understand, he's come back. If he hadn't acted that way, our relationship would have grown more distant with each day. Basically, he was right. He's almost always right. My pits to trap goats were primitive, almost dangerous for the poor animals. I covered them with branches, and the goats hurt themselves when they fell. Friday perfected the trap by using a net. The animals run no risk anymore, and it's much easier to pull them out of the pit. time goes by. More pleasantly now that Friday and I are real friends. His talents are many. He can shoot fish as well as birds with his bow. When he dives, I'm terrified. Sometimes he disappears for so long that I think he's drowned. It seems impossible for a human being to move underwater with such ease. There. He always reappears. I tell him he resembles a fish, which annoys him very much. With the greatest care, I begin his education again. I teach him the use of gold. That's gold, Friday.
Gold?
Gold. Yes. It's highly treasured by white men.
Treasured?
In my country, you can buy anything you like with gold.
What is that? What is buy?
To have things, or if you prefer, to satisfy all your desires. You understand?
Understand. With gold, all permitted. Can do anything.
That's it.
Then you, me, leave this island?
No. No, it's impossible. All this gold wouldn't be enough, Friday. I hope he understood. What are you doing?
Me plant gold. Gold then grow much. And with much gold, we can buy boat. Me very stupid. I never understand. You say all this gold not buy boat. We make gold grow.
Gold doesn't grow, Friday. I only want to explain that in my country, we're able to buy many things.
Anything I want?
Almost, yes. Nearly everything.
Have many friends?
Many.
Many goats? Many wife?
Yes, maybe.
Much love?
That's another story.
Right to kill enemies?
Yes, in wartime.
And have slaves?
Yes. If you want to have one.
Have gold. Never sick, never die. And with much gold, much more, we leave this island and go to your country.
We can't, Friday. To leave the island, we must have a ship. And then you buy a ship with gold. But only if there is one. Now do you understand?
You say, have everything, do everything.
Not entirely, Friday. Not exactly. You haven't understood.
Yes. Me understand. With gold, not have everything. With gold, you buy only men, not things. An island. There are but two men. You, me. You, with gold, you can only buy me. Me can only buy you if I have gold. Me understand everything.
The years pile up. At present, I'm quite resigned to my fate. I've given up hope of seeing England again, and I'm becoming less English. I let my beard grow, and I've lost all sense of vanity. Thank you. Our herds are growing. Our plantations are spreading. Our stores are accumulating. We have enough to eat for years. We continue working mainly as a distraction. We are the absolute rulers of a fertile domain in perpetual springtime. We have no taxes, fees, war, or village idiots. Our peaceful souls turn toward God with ease. All the spirit, all the ambitions of my youth now seem to me more juvenile than the toys of my childhood. I even find myself wondering if I could leave this island now in the event that a ship did visit us.
Oh! Over there! Over there! On the water! A big house! I saw a big house, yes! On the water!
What? A boat?
No! House! House!
Come on! They are men from my country. They're friends. Hurry, let's prepare them a good meal. Well, what are you waiting for?
You go away without me.
No, no, Friday, of course not. You're coming too. Come on.
Before showing myself, I prefer to learn more about it. It looks like a mutiny. Killed in a few seconds. I was wise to stay out of sight.
And what are we gonna do now?
You don't do a thing. You just obey orders, understand?
I understand.
That's fine. Has anyone anything else to say?
Out of the usual shipping lanes. Only pirates venture this way. I seem to attract them. If they find us, they'll massacre us.
The boys just took care of the captain, and we threw the petty officer into the water. So the ship belongs to me. Speaking of water, we didn't come this far just to pick flowers.
My parrot has lived in freedom since the first pirates came.
Well, what's the matter with you?
I didn't say anything.
If it wasn't you, then who just talked?
It wasn't me.
One thing I'd like to know is who taught him how to speak.
Didn't I tell you that there was someone around?
We be able to keep out of their way. They're bound to discover my cave. The cannibals never leave the beach, but they are sure to search everywhere. I think we can bid a final farewell to our paradise. How can we defend ourselves? We're only two against a dozen pirates who kill as easily as they breathe. There is hardly any hope for us.
Thank you.